Hey guys, and welcome to another draft here. And looks like we're doing some Shadows of Innistrad. I just got back from Grand Prix Albuquerque, where I did not make top 64. I made 69th place, which is unfortunate. But we did 5-1 our drafts on day two, so that's good. I'm pretty sure Sin Prodder's the pick here. He's pretty good. Even if he was just a 3-2 menace, he's good, but you know, when you add the fact that you get to draw cards with them, it's even better. And I think red is one of the better colors in this format, along with green and black and white. Everything but blue. Blue's not great. But this is actually an interesting pick. We have Ghoulsteed, which is very good. 4/4/5. That can come back whenever he wants. We also have Getstaff Arsonists, which is very good. We have a Halpak Wolf, which is just fine. And we have a Twins of Maurer Estate. So now we have to make a... We actually don't have to make a choice yet. We can just take the Arsonists or the Halpak Wolf. I think the Arsonists are a little better. They're very big in this format. And if you... And it lets us go into werewolves or humans. I think we're just going to take the Arsonists here. Olivia's Bloodsworn is a pretty good reason to be black, I think. We don't have any vampires yet, but it's a 2-1 flyer for 2. It's also got a red ability. And there are only other options are Crow, which is, I think, worse. Malevolent Whispers and Neonate. Again, there's no good green cards in here either, so I'm going to take the Bloodsworn and assume that's a sign. We also have a Tenacity in here, which is a decent white card. I like Blood Mad Vampire a lot, but we don't have any discard outlets, and Dance with Devils I think is just better. So we're going to take a Dance with Devils. Also, if we get any Pyre Hounds, this will trigger that as well. Convicted Killer is real sweet, and it looks like one of the only picks in this pack that really we care about. And we're not going to play Merciless Resolve, even if we're not black for some reason. Intrepid Provisioner and Briarbridge Patrol are not worth taking a card that is extremely playable in our colors. Alright. Yeah, I like all these picks so far. So, no complaints. Not one single complaint. So basically devils and wolves right now. With we might not even be black. I mean, it definitely depends on what comes, but red, you can pretty much pair red with anything. There's a red-blue deck, there's a red-black deck, there's a red-green deck, and there's even a red-white deck. So, but we're not going to make that decision now because we're going to take this Reduced to Ashes, which is a pretty sweet removal spell. I think Reckless Scholar is the next best card in this pack, and there's no reason not to take Reduced to Ashes here. A nice thing about Reduced to Ashes is that it also helps our Delirium, if that's a thing, because it's a sorcery. Not thrilled with Tormenting Voices. It does let us discard a land. Stromkirk Mentor is not terrible. We can put a counter on our Bloodsworn or any other vampires that we may get. I think we just take the Mentor here. And another Convicted Killer, which is actually pretty sweet. I don't think Cryptolithic Rite is worth anything. It's the first week this set's been out online, so it's definitely a consideration. If it's worth like 5 tickets, we'd probably just take that, but pick the Brain, choose a non-land card. None of these cards are really fantastic. I might just take the Moldgraph Scavenger because it's a potential 3/4. I think that's what we're gonna do. I'm not gonna play any of the other cards, so. Oh, and the Ghoulsteed actually came back. So did a Skeleton, which could be very good. I think it's Ghoulsteed, though. Like, this card's very good. And it's probably gonna be harder to get than a Skeleton. But Skeletons are taken pretty highly, I think. We're not gonna play Hound or Structural Distortion. I do like a Neonate, though. If we get anything like the vampire that puts counters on all your guys, the Neonates goes up a little bit. And rush of adrenaline, just fine. We're not going to play Hulking Devil, but it's still not bad to have. Yeah, I think this deck is sweet. I think we would play, we could definitely play all 11 of these cards. I could see Neonate not making the cut, but everything else I actually don't have a problem playing at all. Oh, this forest is what we wanted to come back. Helps us cast any of these green cards in the sideboard if we choose to go that route. Game Trail. Oh, Pack Guardian is probably one of the best green uncommons. Near Hearth Chaplain is a significantly good white uncommon. Another good green uncommon. Murderous Compulsion is probably the pick here, I'd imagine. It's a little sad not being able to take this Pack Guardian, but actually, maybe we just do take the Pack Guardian. I don't even know. It doesn't feel right. It doesn't feel great giving up Bloodsworn and Ghoulsteed. Murderous Compulsion is pretty reasonable. Yeah, I think we're going to stay the course. We passed a lot of green, and not as much black. Hunters in the background going a little crazy. Obsessed with Skinner is also very, very good. So is Watcher in the Web. I think we're just going to take the Crow here. God, I don't even want to take these black cards anymore. I feel like we're just compromising. Skin Invasion's not terrible either. Force them to attack, kill their guy, get a 3-4. 3-4 is actually pretty sizable in this format. Could just be, I think it's just Crow of Dark Tidings maybe. That's not better than Skinner though, but we don't actually have a Delirium strategy either, so I'm gonna take the Skin Invasion, actually. I think I'm a bigger fan of that. Here's a Deadweight, and a Reduced to Ashes, and an Arsonists, and a Geist Blast, and a Scourge Wolf. Geist Blast, we can't actually flash it back, so it might lose a little bit of value there. Scourge Wolf is only a 2-2 first striker, though, without Delirium. Might be a little difficult to cast. I'm pretty sure we just take the Deadweight here. If we are black, which I think we are. And maybe one of those cards will come back, even. Dual Shot is an option. Magnifying Glass and Brain in a Jar are not great. Rabid Bite's pretty sweet. It's probably the best card in this pack. Paranoid Parish Blade's also fine. I think we just have to take the Dual Shot and not love it. Yeah, we're just going to take Dual Shot here. Tooth Collector is an excellent little pick here. Rancid Rats and Throttle are also great, but Tooth Collector is very, very good. Yeah, we're just going to take Tooth Collector. Could potentially kill something. Another Dance with Devils. That's pretty sweet. Also, another Skeleton and an Uncaged Fury, but we don't actually have any discard outlets right now, so it's not like we're looking for a ton of ways to discard things. Ghoulcaller's Accomplice is great. I think we'd rather have a 2-drop than a 3-drop here, and this guy also is gives us a little late game as well. I'm gonna take this Ghoulcaller's Apprentice. Pale Rider, that's what we want. Do we have anything great to discard? Not yet. We have Murderous Compulsion, which is sweet, but actually this gives us incentive to pick up more Madness cards. 3-3 for 2 with Skulk is real good. I'm going to take this Ember Eye Wolf. Oh, the Crow came back. Interesting. I'm not going to take Foul Orchard. I don't think we're going to be splashing anything. Crow is actually just fine. And the Arsonist came back. That's pretty sweet. So this is actually a lot of cards right now. We're just take the Brand in the Jar. It's a rare. We're probably not going to play the other cards. Yeah, now the cat's making noise. All right, so you guys are getting all kinds of treats today. Oh, and a rancid rat came back? Man, somebody loves us. I'm going to put this neonate in the sideboard. Probably going to put dual shot in the sideboard too. I'm not a big fan of a dual shot unless I know there's some targets. Everything else seems fine. I don't like Mentor right now because we only have one other vampire. So I'm going to take out Mentor as well. Ever After is a thing. So is Indulgent Aristocrat. Not really a thing that we care about. I could see Ever After getting like two Arsonists or a Ghoulstead and an Arsonist or a Sin Prodder and a Tooth Collector. And there's a lot of cards that would actually be very good. This guy was also very good for us. Makes me want to put the Neonate and the other vampire back in and just have a vampire theme. Especially when we have two devils to sacrifice. That could be very good. I don't actually hate that. I actually don't care about Ever After in this kind of deck. I'm going to take Indulgent Aristocrat. I think it was very good for me at the Grand Prix. And it's kind of a... Like, it puts counters on all your vampires, on each vampire you control. So, it's actually pretty good. I think we're going to take Kindly Stranger here. It's one of the best uncommons. We also have ways to disc... Oh, wow! Elusive Tormentor and a Diagraph Colossus in the same pack? Unfortunately, I don't think we're going to have a lot of zombies in our graveyard. We only have a zombie bird. And I think we're taking Elusive Tormentor 100%. This card is insane. And ideally, either Murderous Compulsion, Village Messenger, or Colossus will come back. But this is also a vampire as well. So you can see our vampire theme getting a little thicker. So this is 24 cards. I can cut the Ember Eye Wolf. I don't actually care about that guy. Now we're almost more black than red. Our deck looks very sweet now. Tell you what, you give me a Fiery Temper, we'll call it a day. Then we'd have a Reduced to Ash, a Mindrak Demon. Wow. I think we're just taking Mindrak Demon here and just having infinite powerful rare. How many rares do we have right now? Okay, just two. But this is still better than everything else in the pack. Yeah, we're just taking that guy. And ideally, what's the card that we wanted to come back? Ever After will come back. So that if we mill something with Mindrak Demon, we can get it back with Ever After. This pack also has Rancid Rats, Convicted Killer, and another Pale Rider, so... God, do we want two Pale Riders? And then a Convicted Killer. I think I said that. I think I said Pale Rider, Convicted Killer, and Rancid Rats. I don't think we want another Rats. I don't think we want another... I think we're just going to take Pale Rider here. None of these cards have Madness. Alms, but we're not going to play an Alms. Angel of Deliverance. I'm just going to hate this. I don't feel like dealing with this ridiculously powerful 8 drop. Oh, we have a Sanitarium Skeleton, which is great for all our things like Tormentor, Mindrak Demon, and Pale Riders. That's fantastic. I'm going to take the Skin Invasion out now. Still need to make two cuts here. Jeez. And nothing great here. Just a little prowess guy. And an explosive apparatus. This is a vampire, though. So it does work with our Indulgent Aristocrat. I don't think we're going to play apparatus. Actually, apparatus helps Delirium. I don't think we need any 2-drops, though. I might cut one Pale Rider. I don't think... I don't want the... we don't have enough cards to actually make him useful. So I don't just want to have to throw away cards to play a Pale Rider. I think we'll... What's more important, the vampire theme or the delirium? I think it's the vampire theme. And we'll just take this apparatus, I guess. So it all works out. And none of these. I'm going to take the aim high. It's a combat trick. Now we have to cut three cards from this deck. Crow is probably one of them. Which is weird because Crow's good, but it's one of our weakest cards here. I'll just take a Tormenting Voice, actually. Pyrehound, sure. Two cuts now. So our vampires look like Aristocrat, Mentor, Elusive Tormentor, Mage, Bloodsworn, Human, Human, Deviled, Human, Human. Eh, we'll take a Merciless Resolve. I think we already have a Hulking Devil in our sideboard. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Yeah, this is actually a decent amount of vampires. Like, we can sacrifice anything, including these Dance with Devil tokens. And what do we need Delirium for? Basically just Mind Rack Demon, right? Also, our opponents can very well put lands into our graveyard. Oh, also Kindly Stranger. So our deck does have a... How many sorceries do we have? One sorcery. I'll take this mount. Oh, we have an enchantment, actually, which is nice. So, enchantment, sorcery, instant. Another sorcery. There's 18 creatures. We might have to cut a creature. Maybe we just cut, like, an arsonist. I think we actually do cut an arsonist. Maybe a convicted killer? Also, two instants. So you will go over here in the instant pile. And then the artifacts and enchantment. Oh, alright, that's cool. I wasn't doing anything magic, don't worry. Alright, so let's... Artifacts and enchantments. Now we have room to put them in different piles. I guess we'll do that. Creature, 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 creature. Also, the crow helps our delirium, but we don't actually have many delirium cards. It's basically just Mind Rack Demon, I think. Oh, and Kindly Stranger. We already know. We went over this. And Tooth Collector, I guess. But, the Tooth Collector might not even be relevant. One cut. These guys go on the instant pile. You go on the sorcery pile. There's a million creatures in this deck. This deck is very creature intensive. I'm pretty sure we play Mind Rack Demon, right? It's a big concern of mine to play Mind Rack Demon. Our opponent let us take four and then they kill it. That's real sad. We have a lot of card types in our deck, which is nice. Tempted to just take Explosive Apparatus out. Yeah, I think I'm just taking the apparatus out. Not thrilled with it. And I think the creature and instant or sorcerer are guaranteed to be in the graveyard, so we need land and enchantment, I guess. Ugh, that's rough. Yeah, especially when we only have like one enchantment. So I don't think we can actually... We might have to keep in Explosive Apparatus. This is a quick build too, so we're actually pretty short on time as well. We have about 3 minutes. This is actually much tougher than I thought it would be. Maybe we take out the Mentor, but then our Indulgent Aristocrat gets worse. Like, I want to have a bunch of targets for... I guess this guy's fine. This guy's basically a 5-drop. You rarely want to cast him on 4. I'm not in love with the mage. I think we're just taking the mage out because it's basically a... Like, we only have... We have very few spells, basically, is what I'm getting at here. So I think we're going to... I think this is our deck. And it's actually surprisingly more black than red now. So we're just going to do 9-8. I definitely don't want... less red. We want red early for... All right, so we'll submit like this, and we'll see you in the round.